Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Annie already announced the name of the song, so please stand if you're able, and we will sing, I sing praises to your name. Words that should be on the screen. To the Lord, to sing praises to your name, O Most High.
To declare your steadfast love in the morning and your faithfulness by night.
To the music of the lute and the harp, to the melody of the lyre.
For you, O Lord, have made me glad by your work. At the works of your hands, I sing for joy.
Congregation to get involved in our next two songs. If someone would like to call out one of your favorite songs. Patty already wanted 408, so we'll do that one, but we have another one after that song. So we're going to be singing The Gift of Love down on page 408 for, it'll be verses 1 and 3. Can someone else pick out the next one? What's it?
Mm-hmm. We forgot one very important thing, rapper, Noah.
No. I'm not.
Well, it's
Talker.
His version. His version.
Thank you.
country western song, and the writers of the song did a very excellent job with the lyrics, because no matter what happens, no matter what situation we're in, there was Jesus. Whether it's good, bad, whether we think it's good or bad or whatever, but please pay attention to the words, because I think they can all apply to each of our lives. Every time I try to make it on my own, every time I try to stand, I start to fall. And for all those lonely roads I've traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I've even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus. For the man who needs amazing kind of grace, for forgiveness at a price I couldn't pay. I'm not perfect, no, I thank God every day. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus on a mountain in the valleys. There was Jesus in the shadows of the alleys. There was Jesus in the fire, in the flood. Always is and always was. No, you were always there. In the waiting, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a friend who never was there when the pieces. Every moment, every minute, every time I'm not going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus.
Some birthdays. Luann has a birthday on the 19th, and
today.
Yeah, today. And Garrett Hummel has a birthday on the 24th. Judy Reichrich had a nice birthday. Her birthday was last week. The Lenten service, I guess, on Wednesday was very, very good. And John Klinger got a good doctor's report. We need to continue our prayers for Deb and Larry Cooper, and also the Chapman family and the Watts family.
Dad and Mom and I would like to thank everybody for their prayers and cards while Dad was in the hospital rehab. It was a scary start, but God brought us through. Thank you.
I have two friends with health concerns. First is Kathy R., who's in the hospital. She had a knee replacement 3 years ago in her left knee. And the other Friday in the snow, she fell on her porch and fell on her left knee. And because of the hardware, it cracked her femur from her knee to her hip. So she's in rehab, trying to learn to walk again. The second is my friend Melissa G. Again, for health issues, she is battling breast cancer. She found it early. Prognosis is good. She has finished her chemo, and now she starts on to radiation, the tough stuff. So please keep both of my friends in prayer, if you would, please.
Any others?
I don't know these people personally, but my mom knows somebody. No, so this family, the husband worked at Geisinger. They moved. They're the Balakoff family. Their 2-year-old son had, I guess, fell in the pool and he was pronounced brain dead. So they are harvesting some of his organs to save some other people. Who's two? I believe they're doing that either tonight or tomorrow. But just prayers for their family. Prayers for the families of who are, you know, receiving the organs, and just for that time, it's just a, you know, just really hit my heart. So, just prayers for them.
I'd like to thank all of our musicians and our singers and everyone who volunteered to share their talent today. And unfortunately, my daughter Anna, who was supposed to sing a solo, will not be here today. She got sick last night during the night. And so we'll save her song for another Sunday and make it special music then. Thank you.
Thank you. And I saw a couple hands over here.
Please pray for my brother Carl tomorrow. He's having open heart surgery.
And prayers for Howard T.
Just an update, our daughter-in-law is doing well with her pregnancy. She still has some discomfort, but she's hanging in there and we're getting down to the wire. And Jeff, if anybody could follow Bonnie, it's you.
I want to piggyback on Tim's announcement about thanks to all the musicians, especially the young people who are playing in our tone chimers today. They're busy people and they take time out to come to practice. So thankful for all of them and for all our guests that are here too.
For the Buggy family and the Dorkowski family, both lost loved ones.
Prayers for my friend Susan Kay, who has metastatic breast cancer.
For 28 years of wedded bliss.
Okay, let us turn to the Lord in prayer. Let us keep in mind those on our prayer list, those that we named aloud, and those that we name quietly in our hearts. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we have set aside this day to celebrate the one great hour of sharing, a time in which we can offer our help and our substance for the work of your kingdom in helping others, especially UMCOR. We have created a special day for this offering, yet you would have us adopt this attitude of sharing all of our days. Bring us to the understanding of joy, of sharing all that we have with others, of reaching out to others in compassion and love, as you have done for us, especially those in need of our prayers and compassion. We hear the words of scriptures about people who wandered in the wilderness, that you fed them until they could prove for themselves. Help us to realize that you have given us all that we need to be those who would bring peace and hope to others. Let us place our trust in you so that our sharing is a reflection of your forgiving and reconciling love. In Jesus Christ, we offer this prayer as the Lord has taught us to pray by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Okay, we're going to continue now with our program, To God Be the Glory.
is it with that?
this time we'll give of our gifts, our tithes, and our offerings.
Song previously picked out for them to do, and they really didn't like it. I said, okay, I'll give you a challenge. So this is a challenge. We did it. We can do it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amendment 504. First and last, 369. Let's issue.
Expense. One person we didn't mention this morning wanted to thank was Eric Anderson, who every Sunday is up at his perch up there taking care of all of our audiovisual needs. And I met Eric this morning at 8 o'clock to go over our slideshow presentation. And it's been several years since we did this song. And since then, the church got a new computer. He wasn't sure if he had saved the pictures. So he said, I have six pictures you sent me. I said, well, that's not going to work. So spent the next 10 minutes looking through the old files, and he found the old pictures. We now have 62 pictures. So thank you, Eric.
Thank you.
A round of applause for Eric. So everyone always talks about a guardian angel. And everybody has one, whether they have passed on or they're still living. And I came upon this song, and this idea popped in my head. It's not my idea. I don't know where they come from. I think they come from God. But I said, wouldn't it be nice to honor those angels that are guardian angels? And this is a song by Alabama, and it's called Angels Among Us. So Eric's going to play a slideshow of all the people that you've sent to us that are our guardian angels. I was walking home from school on a cold winter day. Took a shortcut through the woods, and I lost my way. It was getting late, and I was scared and all alone. But then a kind old man took my hand and led me home. My mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayers. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, show us how to live, teach us how to give, guide us with the light of love. When life held troubled times and had me down on my knees, there's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger, lend a helping hand, a phone call from a friend, just to say I understand. But ain't it kind of funny, at the dark end of the road, that someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope? Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. They wear so many faces, show up in the strangest places, grace us with their mercy in our time of need. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love, to guide us with the light of love. Thank you.
Thank you.